Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. This is Enigma. So today we're going to do Aries for January 2021, the regular reads. After then we're going on towards bonus. We're only left with Libra, I guess. So yeah, Libra is left. Okay. Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus signs in Aries. This is a general reading. Take however this resonates. For personal readings and more accuracy, you can book me on WhatsApp or Instagram. You can follow me on Instagram for tarot-related offers and updates, manifestations, guidance, and short readings, January short horoscopes as well. Subscribe to my channel if you're new here and hit the bell icon for more such videos. Now let's move on towards Aries. What's coming up for you, January? Oh, dealing with a player or someone is having phobia with commitment. This could be a very innocent energy as well. For some of you, there's an age gap. I see like this could be a Pisces, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. They're working on their money. I feel you could be the one working on your money. Yes, Aries, I feel like you're trying to, you know, put hands on different kind of opportunities at career. And you're making a lot. Okay, you're making a fortune, or you will make a fortune. So if you start multitasking, you're going to get a lot. So Aries, you're very determined for your money, and your money is going to rise. If you're in a business, your money is going to go tenfold, like that. Okay, I also see a marriage offer coming in for you, Aries. Someone who could be a Pisces, someone who's very abundant, rich, very loving, caring. Okay, everything they're ready to give to you. And this is going to bring a lot of emotional abundance, happiness in you, in your family. And I feel, Aries, you may be going to places. You may have to travel as well to different places for work. Yes, so your focus is on making money, and I feel like you're going to make a huge amount of money. And I feel like there's definitely a solid offer that's coming into your life. And this is going to come slowly, okay? This is not going to be like abrupt, not in January right away. But I feel you focusing on your career, and that's when you find your true soulmate. And they're going to be actually your soulmate with the King and Queen of Pentacles. You guys will be in equal level, on equal page with money, okay, with status. And I feel you are the one who's going to approach them. And there's going to be a lot of exchange of communication and understanding about your work. And I do see this person supporting you at your work as well. Are you supporting them? So the moment you meet them, there's going to be a lot of emotional fulfillment, excitement, passion. There will be a lot of love between you guys. There will be a lot of mirroring of each other. Soulmate. This is exact soulmate, okay? I feel like you may meet them in a different land, okay? In a different city state as well. Or continent. Whew. Okay, let me see. Why do I get Seven of Swords? Your person could be a Gemini as well, a Cancer as well. Okay, there is this someone, maybe a Pisces, who has commitment issues. Someone over here has a major commitment issues. Okay, you want love, but they have commitment issues. They are hiding something. Maybe they have something from the past that they don't want you to know. And that is the reason why they're not ready to commit to you. Okay, so there's some mystery around this person. So before, you know, jumping right away, try to know more about them. This person is showing you, or will show, a lot of interest in you. Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. They could be someone you meet online, or they could be from a different place, or there's a distance between you guys, long distance. Okay, so they might approach you, and you might fall in love with them, and then you get to know that they are already in affair with someone else, or they were cheating, okay, or they were lying about certain things. So you may get to know that, and you may feel hurt in the end. So you have to be careful. Okay, then there's one soulmate is also there, but you may mistaken someone as your soulmate. So it's gonna happen very, very slowly. So keep your eyes open. This could be a Leo as well. I see a new beginning in love definitely happening. Someone is going to offer you a big cup of love. Okay, this is a soulmate of yours, but you may end up, you know, or focusing on the wrong wrong option. Okay, there are a lot of options. Okay, you will be open to them, but I see you coming across a lot of manipulators on the way of finding your soulmate. Okay, yes, there are a lot of manipulators, and out of these there will be that one person who will be in love with you. Scorpio energy. Okay, Scorpio, Pisces, Cancer, they will be very much in love with you. Aries, please. You may definitely meet this person at a different place. Okay, or they may have to come from a different place to travel towards you. Aries, Sagittarius, Leo, or you may have to go somewhere else and find your soulmate there. And you have options. It's not like it will be just one person coming in your life. There are more than one people interested or will come towards you. So you are the one who's getting to decide. So I feel like the moment you see them, this could be a reconciliation as well. Someone from the past coming back into your life and realizing that you're the one for them and you're their soulmate. And that's when you disconnect from all the other things and focus on them. Okay, that will also happen. Because there will be a lot of passion between you guys. Lots of passion, like attraction between you guys. Very soon, I see this person trusting you a lot. You may have trust towards them and they may have trust towards you. The connection will be based upon trust. And now it's the time you meet this person, okay? If not very late, then it's going to be you who has to take that first step towards them. Listen to your intuition. Your intuition is actually telling you the right thing. If you feel like this person is into you, then there's a high chance they are into you. So trust your intuition. It's going to lead you through. Time to give rather than take. You could be dealing with a Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising in Venus. I feel like you've taken enough. Now it's time to give towards that person. Okay, this could be vice versa situation as well. If you've given too much, then they will give you more. So the things are going to get balanced, and I feel like you're working on your talent as well. You're working on your career, and it's going to give you a lot of results. Your intuition will guide you through at every step. Okay, whatever you need to do, follow your heart. You are supported by the angels, by the guides around you. Okay, and they're telling you through. Their number is 222-888. Your effort are going to pay you the results. Aries, please. Happiness. Finally, you're going to be very happy. Finally, all the struggle has paid off well. Finally, you're going to get the result of whatever you've done in the past. Giving and receiving. Yes, you're going to get what you give out. So, be more giving. Flow. Go with the flow. If your heart tells you to do something like this, go for it. You may have a lot of challenges, but you'll face head on and you're going to build a strong foundation for yourself. You're going to be successful. You're going to rise up in your career as well. And I feel like you know where you're going. You know what you're doing. Some of you are 43 at age. Okay, or your person maybe. Or you feel a very strong connection towards someone. Okay, someone from the past. And you know that this is the person that I'm talking about. Okay. Let me see some angels. What do they have to say to you? Ready to love again. Yes, this is a time where this situation will, start afresh again with new love, with new energy of love. And you're ready to embrace that. More cards, please, for our Aries. So all this while you're going to follow what your heart feels like. So there are two options around you, okay? Or you may be trying to balance your love and your money. Okay, yeah, that's what I get. Your money is going to get better. You may be working on your money so much, and you're going to enhance. You're going to get abundant. Yay, Ace of Swords and Ace of Wands. There's a new beginning at work and a new chapter in passion and love. Okay, Aries, there's a new chapter happening. New chapter in love, new chapter in work. So this is the reading for my Aries. Very interesting read. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, do not forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel. Hit the bell icon and do mention in the comment section how this resonated. Till then, we'll see you next time. Bye.